Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and salam sejahtera I bid to Mr. Jail. So today I would be presenting on the assignment one, which is solving theft crime by using graph theory. Okay, my name is Sarah Aisha binti Ismani and I'm from Bachelor of Information Technology. Okay. So the question is, police have caught four suspects for a theft case, Alan, Benoit, Charlie, and Dominic, and each of them make these statements. Alan said that, I'm not the thief, while Benoit said, Alan is the thief. Charlie also said that, I'm not the thief, while Dominic said, Benoit is the thief. So police know that there is only one thief, and only one of them is not telling the truth. So it means that the other three are telling the truth. So we have to investigate and figure out who is the thief. So I denote A as Alan, B as Benoit, Charlie would be denoted as C, and Dominic will be D. Okay, so Alan made this statement that says, I'm not the thief. So in this statement, we can assume that Alan is accusing all of other suspects as thief, but not himself. So we have to draw arrows that will be pointed out to all other suspects that he is accusing. Therefore, it will be not included himself. So the next one, Benoit said Alan is the thief. So we have to draw the arrow that will point out to Alan. And the next one, Charlie also said that I'm not the thief. Therefore, the arrow will be pointed out to all the other suspects other than himself. And Dominic said that Benoit is a thief, so the arrow will be directly pointed to Benoit. So in this process, we have to figure out how many of them accused for each particular suspect. So we start from Alan. How many of them accused Alan? So for this process, we have to eliminate arrow that is from Alan himself, which is the blue arrow, this one, and also the arrows that is not directly related to Alan, which is this one, and this one, and this one. Therefore, the only arrow that directly pointed at Alan would be these two only, which is from Benoit and Charlie. Okay, so from this arrow, we have to make a statement. So we have to make this statement that is listing out who is telling the truth. So for the first person, Alan, which is we denoted as A here. So we write it down, jot it down, how many of them accuse him for the theft. So we can see that there is only two arrows, which means only two people is accusing him for the theft. Okay, so for the next one, how many of them accuse Benoit for the theft? So as the process will be the same as before, we have to eliminate the arrow that is not directly related to Benoit, and also the arrow that is from Benoit. So after eliminating all the arrows, we have three arrows that is directly pointed at Benoit. So we have to jot it down here as well. So as Alan, there are two people accusing him, and Benoit, there are three people accusing him for the theft. So the process will be the same for Charlie. And here we can see that only one of them is pointing out at Charlie for the theft. So only one person is accusing him. And also for the Dominic. And we can see that there is two arrows. So therefore we can jot down that two people are accusing Dominic for the theft. Okay, so from this statement alone that we have jotted down here, we can come up with the conclusion and we can figure out which one of them is the thief. Okay, so as you can see here, police know that there is one thief and only one of them is not telling the truth. The other three are telling the truth. Okay, which means among these four people, there is only one thief, and obviously the thief will not point out himself. Therefore, we can come up with theory that other than the thief himself, the other three suspects will point out to him. Therefore, we can see here, okay, so there are four people here, right? So if we assume that there is only one thief, that means the other three is not the thief. So we can conclude that the three of them will point out to the same person, which is the thief. Therefore, we can see here, B has the most people accuse him for the theft. Therefore, we can conclude that B is the thief among these four suspects. Okay, I hope the explanation is enough and it can be applied for any crime scenario. So I think that's all for me. Thank you so much.